I bought this set of Autel TPMS sensors. This is kind of the latest and greatest MX sensor. It claims to have 98% coverage. And I bought this for my Honda Pilot 2023 model year in order to get a set of winter tires going. These are my winter tires that I sourced from the dealership, and I had Costco actually install a new set of MX sensor TPMS units in these tires. Now, they didn't work initially with the Honda, and Autel says when you try to program them, they say, well, you need to have less than 10 PSI in the tires. So because I'm doing this after the tires have been deployed, I'm actually going to let the air out of the tires all the way down below 10 PSI and see if we can program them. Okay, we should be pretty good. You can see now we've got about 8 PSI in the tires, pretty much flat. PMS programmer that I never intended to get. This is a TS508WF from Autel, and it's used specifically for Autel sensors. Here's our TPMS sensor, and you see I've got a cable and the pigtail is plugged in under the dashboard there to the car's OBD sensor. And so what we're going to do is going to say advanced mode. I have to remember how to do this. Okay, and then select your car. It's nice that it keeps the defaults. All right, and there is our version. And let's go program sensor and then copy by OBD, connect OBD and turn ignition on. And we say yes. And so it's going to read those sensor IDs. All right. And that is how we did it. Oops, sorry, cancel. So that's what you do after. So, yep. All right, so now that these are loaded into the TPMS unit, then we can go around to each of the wheels and program each of those. See on the left, it says left front, right rear, left rear. That's what those symbols mean. Anyway, so that's what we're going to do. So in order to program, I'm going to go to this advanced mode. I'll select Honda, Pilot. And I did already update the software in this unit. And so you see section number one is 1/2023 to 12/2023. All right, and I'm going to program the sensor. So let's go to program. You click yes. And I'm going to select copy by OBD. So copy by OBD. And now it says use the data stored previously from the engine control unit ECU. Yes. All right, sensor one. So I'll say yes. All right, now what I have to do is go down here is hold it next to the sensor and we'll see what happens. I've never done this. I don't know if it'll work. Hey, looks like it's working. This is very good news. Until you drop that pressure, you'll get no sign of life. The only thing you can do is you can actually read the sensor and see if it's there, so you know that the sensor's working. Okay, so press any key to continue. Okay, great. That's fantastic. Okay, we're going to do number two, but I have to go and let the air out of that tire as well, too. And we'll go around the vehicle and do all four tires. So you notice on the left side of number one, it's left front sensor, so don't mix those up. Then we're going to do right front, then right rear, then left rear in order. So I'm just starting the car up now. All right, we still see a TPMS issue, and I know the sensors are now programmed. So apparently the Honda has to drive around a little bit, so we're gonna drive it around and see if the car now recognizes those sensors. Okay, so I've driven the vehicle just down to the end of the block and back, and all of a sudden, the TPMS sensors lit up, leading me to declare victory, and they're working fine. So now I'm gonna actually use the car to help me get the tires to the proper tire pressure. Here's how you activate an Autel MX sensor TPMS unit on your new Honda Pilot.
You're going to need to use an Autel brand tool. I'm using the TS508WF. This was recommended by the Autel tech staff. The WF stands for Wi-Fi, and that's how you update the firmware. The activation setup is as follows. You get your sensors, you get your tool, then you update the tool's firmware. As of mid-February 2024, you had to do this. Maybe by the time you get a tool, the firmware will already include the latest Honda models, at least the Honda Pilot. All right, so in order to update the firmware, you have to create an account at Autel. You're gonna have to connect your tool up to your Wi-Fi, and then you're gonna enter your account credentials for your Autel account into the tool, and that's gonna allow it to register and download these firmware update. All right. The next thing you're going to do is copy the existing tire pressure management IDs for each of the tires on your Pilot using an OBD cable that plugs into the Autel tool. Then to program each of the sensors, you're just going to go around to each wheel and you're going to select the corresponding code that's identified by by the tool. So if you're just cloning one for one, you're cloning your Pilot's previous wheels. So if you already mounted the wheels, you're going to have to deflate the tires so they're below 10 PSI. There's no way around that I know of. And that's what the tool will tell you to do if it fails to actually program the sensor. All right? Then all you got to do, obviously after you put the air back in your tires, is drive your Pilot around the neighborhood. It only took about 400 yards for the TPMSs to wake up when I did mine. So pretty straightforward. So my recommendation is if you're a DIY guy or gal and you're gonna source your own wheels, tires, and TPMS sensors, by all means get the OEM Honda sensors. This will avoid any fuss. The Honda Pilot knows how to recognize those sensors according to numerous sources in the Pilot discussion groups. I would only use the aftermarket if you can't get the OEM sensors. And option two would be buy the whole package from your tire dealer. You're gonna buy winter snow tires is what some folks have done. And then it's up to them to make sure the TPMS sensors work with your vehicle, in this case, our new Honda Pilot. Now, there's several TPMS sensor manufacturers, not just Autel. And each tire dealer, a major chain, is going to have a preferred programmer that they like to use and a preferred sensor that they like to use. All right. Last resort, go ahead and get a tool if you really couldn't find the sensors or you couldn't find a tire shop who could program your particular brand of sensor. So my observation here was that Autel MX sensor works great along with the Autel brand tool. No problem at all once I'd identified that I needed the tool to program the sensor. The firmware update over Wi-Fi is by far the easiest. I wouldn't bother with the PC desktop app. I couldn't get it to work because of a serial driver issue that Windows was kind of choking on. My version of Windows is Windows 11. Here's a cost comparison. The Autel sensor is at $120 for a set from a major online vendor that you all know about. The Autel tool was $250, so a total of $368. Whereas if you just bought the OEM Honda sensors and you could get them at MSRP, that'd be $108. You may have to pay more than that. My local dealer, I think, quoted me $40 each, I think. But anyway, your mileage may vary. At the end of the day, the Honda sensor is going to be the cheapest solution for a DIY, and that would be ideal. I would have done that if I hadn't gotten myself a little far down the road, and it was going to cost me nearly as much to throw away the new sensors and get Honda sensors versus buy the tool. All right, so hope you find that useful. Happy piloting.